Yo, what is up, guys? It's Matt. I'm finally back. So, yeah.
2,000 years later.
Which one are we doing today? I have a lot of suggestions I have to get around to because it's been like literally 1,000 years. So let me check this out. We're gonna be doing Mr. Brownstone today by Guns N' Roses. So, yeah. You guys are ready, which I'm sure you are. It's been long awaited. I guess we'll get right into this. I'm sorry, I gotta pause it right there. Dude, these guys are grooving. That little, like, I don't know, it almost has like a tribalistic feel to it where it's got your little, like, not a bongo, but it's like a, I don't know if it's toms that he's using to make that sound. I know he's got a cowbell in there because I'm hearing it now, but dude, I mean, the percussion on this is nuts because it has like a tribal feel to it, but it's still like very groovy. And the guitar, I mean, oh man, he's just going ham on some freaking sick rhythm. I mean, I hope there's an epic guitar solo in this song because this groove is just nasty. And Axel in this song is very, very so far kind of laid back as far, because I mean, I've listened to a lot of their other stuff so far from you guys, and he definitely has more in him in terms of his range, so we'll see what he ends up doing. But yeah, as far as the groove goes, man, it's freaking sick, man. They got an epic little groove going on. I'm a little bit curious, though. He says he's been dancing with Mr. Brownstone. I don't know who is Mr. Brownstone, or is this just like a metaphor for something? Yeah, you guys just let me know in the comments. But so far, it's freaking grooving, man. Like, this is a groover. It's seeming like it's going to make the playlist, but we're going to keep listening.
No, it won't leave me alone. I used to do a little by the little, what I'm doing, so the little guy.
Experienced some technical difficulties with the camera. As you can see, once again, I told you guys this is a brand new setup, so I'm confused about the camera angle and all that. But what I was tripping about and was getting excited about was that solo is freaking insane. The sustain that he had on that one nasty bend and the little transition they just did there with the drums is nuts, man. Ugh. I love this band, man. I'm so glad that you guys turned me on to them because I've listened to a lot of 80s rock, but there's a few bands that I need to get into that I never got around to, this being one of them. Motley Crue, never got into them. I had a buddy tell me I should listen to them, but I'm saving that for videos. I never got into Led Zeppelin much at all. That's not really 80s, that's more prior to that, it's more like 70s, but I mean, dude, there's so much that you guys open my eyes to, which is just insane. Like, these guys, oh, they rock. But anyways, let's get back into it. Sorry about the difficulties and the pauses, guys, but we're gonna keep rocking this one out, see where it goes. That was it. Ah, that track was freaking good, man. I was hoping it'd be longer like some of those other ones that we've listened to. Ah, that was a really good one. That was probably one of my favorites, guys, honestly, up until this point. I mean, I really, really liked Estranged. Was really good, but it was very more drawn out, more ballady type thing where it had a really deep meaning. This was more just absolutely jamming, man. I mean, the groove on this was nuts, but yeah, the little even with his vocals, I was almost like, this sounds odd, but it almost gives me like, not nursery rhyme as in like Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, but as in like just a catchy little earworm that a kid's like class would sing to like remember something, like Head, Shoulders, Knees and Toes or something. But that sounds weird, but it's just giving me like that vibe of the way it was put together, as far as a little groove in the middle. But I mean, it had a weird like goofy circusy vibe to it, but then it gets into this like nasty little freaking groove part. But I mean, dude, yeah, that was a killer song, guys. It really was. And I'm just knocking them off the list at this point, but I've yet to hear anything bad from Guns N' Roses. I mean, they're so different too, though, because I can, like I said before, just Estranged is a great example. You come from something like that, and then you compare this. They're off two different albums, granted, but I mean, like, that's huge change in tone. But anyways, guys, yeah, this one was an absolute banger, and I appreciate the suggestions. And if you want to hear anything else, just drop anything down below. It could be any band, any song, anything. I listen to it, guys. I listen to anything and everything. But anyways, I appreciate all of you guys for watching, and yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one.